Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. The first thing I'm going to start with, the changes that my laptop is going through is, you know, I'm enjoying that actually. The most important thing for me is to get the message out there. And alhamdulillah, so far, it has been, I've been successful in that regard. Why? Again, I ain't gonna give anyone any credit for anything, but alhamdulillah. La ilaha illallah, Muhammadun Rasulullah. That's it. Aqidat al-Tawheed. And what I wanted to bring to the attention to the United States of America government, it is not an option. It is not civilized against uncivilized. It's not a clash of civilizations. And is not terrorist, and we have to protect ourselves from the barbarian terrorist ISIS and so on and so forth, that the United States of America, well, I don't know, I wouldn't even give them that, you know, prestige, because there is no such thing. It is the Zionist International Terrorist Organization that is running the show and controlling everyone, everywhere. Except China. I will exclude China. They're working on their own. But the rest is controlled by the Zionist terrorist, or the international terrorist organization, As-Sahyuniyya Al-Alamiyya. And if anyone, including the federal government or the CIA or the KGB or the any of you clowns disputing the fact, well, pound sand. Again, there is no la ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. There is no, you know, just do what have, play your own little games. All right. Now, and I'm not saying that in a personal note, because whatever poor Mohammed Chiban or his family or his ex, you know, you guys are little, you know. I'm having fun, actually. I'm walking circles around you, like my friend said one time to one of the managers there or whatever it is. Well, I thought that she was my friend, but this is another. What I found out that everything there is pretty planned, and I, you know, there is no random thing, all right? You know, all this muck, and la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, hasbuna Allah wa ni'ma al-wakeel. Anyway, let me proceed. The define the civilized and the uncivilized. Back when I first traveled through Europe, all right, I would say, because London, England, and I learned about the politics and how Hizb al-Shaytan fighting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger khayru khalq Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alright, by doctorating and brainwash and enslaving the minds of the masses. especially the youth. They target the youth. Why? Because they are the leaders. They are the one that change comes about with them. They are the one that stood up and destroy the tyrants, all of them. Of course, he didn't do that because they are strong and, you know, because aqidat al-tawheed. La ilaha illallah Muhammadun Rasulullah. That's it. That's it. Okay? And it's not some that is by choice. It's not some that we choose or they choose to be all bruh bid-dam min ifdikia, whatever. It is sunnatullah, deenullah. We have no other choice. And this is the thing that we have to understand. If someone wanted, or some country wanted to be doing exactly, it's not going to happen except if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has allowed and permitted and decreed that this is going to be their fate. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow His mercy, then success and Sirat al-Mustaqim will be implemented. Al-Mulk lillah, He give to whoever He please. Al-Hidayah from Allah, He give to those that bestow His mercy upon them. That's it. Bottom line. And if we figure it out and understand it, we might earn the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Until then, we will be going with the shaitan, taking us in a space, whatever, the fastest way out of the Sirat al-Mustaqim to the hellfire. Okay? So for a nation, again, to claim to be the only superpower, then stand up and claim leadership and claim responsibility and do it right. Don't listen to this Netanyahu and all these clowns out there, or Sisi or whatever, or Congress or Senate, you know, or Illuminati, actually Illuminati, the Freemasons and the Mafia. Okay, that's it. It's so easy. La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Now, civilized and uncivilized again. When you live in a society that governor or governed by man-made system, someone, they call themselves the founding fathers or the Zubat al-Ahrar, excuse me, or the Republican, whatever, or the Communist Party, or whatever there are. It's not gonna happen. Why? Because it's La ilaha illallah Muhammadun Rasulullah. There is one way to live and lead and make it. And we might who might earn the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bottom line. Now, civilized and uncivilized, when children are victimized by their immediate family, fathers, mothers, teachers, priests and rabbis and homegrown imam, and then what do you expect? What do you expect? And this is the difference between a civilized society, which is only one, La ilaha illallah Muhammadun Rasulullah, Ummati Muhammad, Khayru Khalqillah, with Kitabullah, Al-Quran Al-Kareem, and Sunnati Rasulihi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is it, fellas. This is it. There is no other, you know, well let's make a, you guys are smoking good hashish. Woke up. Now, civilized again and uncivilized. When everything done because the mighty dollar or the mighty dinar or the mighty dirham or the mighty riyal or yen or ruby or basils, whatever it is fee, then shaitan will be your leader. Will be the one, you know, running you. Why? Because we worship our hawa. Worship our hawa. And why I'm directing this to the United States of America government? Because you've been hijacked and you got no power. Why? Because corrupted. Sick, whatever their sexual preferences, that's some that they have to answer. But don't go there and commit crimes against everyone and everything. And tell them, oh, this is how you have to live. Now, for those among us that living any sin, human being that can distinct and understand sin, then if you follow that shaitanic system and be a good role model citizen and do all of this and then commit all these crimes and think that you will have a free ticket, think again. No one has any excuse. No one. Again, if you are sane and you can understand and distinct. Why? Because again, we all been created on the fitrah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our Rabb, our Lord, is no, you can't, you know. And that's why I choose Surah number 31, Luqman. And I put it, and I'm going to put this video on the same page. And I wanted someone to, I got it in Arabic. Quran al-Kareem. The store the constitution from for everyone and everything. The steward, if you're a human being or anything for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creation. To live, this is a loss. And it is so, again, it talks to everyone and everyone with, again, with a little education can. You can't be an imam and a scholar or ulama, you know, like tafsir or legislate or, you know, give advice, because again, the Quran has their own sheikhs and imams and scholars and people that they spend all their life to learn and teach. That's why to be a decent, a Muslim human being and follow Dinul Haq, it's the Quran talks right to us. And with the translation of the meanings of the Quran in all of languages and the availability of everything that you can hear and you can listen, you can Google, you can do whatever, apps or what have you. Use it and learn for your own sake to save your own little red wagon. That's it. Bottom line. All right. Now, if you allow yourself to be brainwashed and victimized and being a zombie, you're not gonna get away when, you know, we all, anyway. Please do yourself a favor. Civilized and uncivilized. When all these crimes are committed by us to us, financial and otherwise, everything, and there is no such thing that Egypt or Saudi Arabia, it's everywhere, everywhere. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. What I experience living in both societies, or you know, the West, the East and the West, what they call themselves or claim to be a Muslim countries, morals and values and the respect of the rule of the law in the European or the Western world is, and you know, the Asian, there is no dispute that they follow. Why? Because they respect the rule of law. Sadly to say, in the what they call themselves the Muslim, where the Muslims are, إن لم تستحي فاصنع ما شئت. There is no nothing. إذا الإيمان ضاع فلا أمان ولا دنيا لمن لم يحمي دينا. There is no nothing stop them. Every crime that we see in here and we discussed with is happening there by the people that they know. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. That they have that responsibilities to take that beautiful deen and be a da'iyah, be a messenger. We are not, we don't own anything. We are created for one reason. La ilaha illallah Muhammadun Rasulullah. That's it. إعلاء كلمة الله سبحانه وتعالى. It's not because we are going and having, make money and get, whatever, liquor store or whatever, and, let's hire the Mexicans because we don't have to pay them that much, or hire the illegal Arabic Muslim people and pay them nothing. And it's unbelievable. Unbelievable. Go lie about anyone and anything just to get paid, working for the FBI or the CIA or what have you. Criminals! And they thought that someone is going to save them. Hasbi Allah wa ni'mal wakeel. Hasbi Allah wa ni'mal wakeel. Now, again, civilized and uncivilized. When you don't own anything, which we don't, and we use it as a revolving accounts and disposable items in the system to make some that is not there. You see, economics, you can sell money with money, and that's proven. That's why the world is the stage that we are now. That's why communism prevailed back then, 100 and some years ago. Before was capitalism. Al-ghaya tubarrir al-wasila. The end to justify the means. Then the Commonwealth came every, that's why. You can't, we can't. It's riba. It is injustice. It is crimes. It's everything, and we are not taking anything with us. These shayateen al-ins are not taking nothing. And they are not coming back. We know that from our great-great-great-great-great-grandfathers, the mummies in the British Museum and everywhere else. Al-Fara'ina. Hasbi Allah wa ni'mal wakeel. Why is this so difficult to understand? We doing everything to ourselves by choice. By choice. Just we agree to be, give me that fix. Give me the Skittles. Or give me whatever I'm living for. That's it. What I'm worshipping. Hasbi Allah wa ni'mal wakeel. Civilized and uncivilized. And I don't want any of you to... No, I don't want to even give you that luxury to sit with me and debate. Debate. And bring evidence and exhibits. And who said what and when. And who did what and when. Hasbi Allah wa ni'mal wakeel. Hasbi Allah wa ni'mal wakeel. La ilaha illallah Muhammadun Rasulullah. I just wanted to do that, and I'm going to... You can listen to it. The Surah Luqman. You can listen to any of the Quran Kareem. Kalamullah. La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. It's out there. And anyone can, learn if you want to. Live and earn this life and the hereafter. La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow mercy upon humanity. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Barakallahu fikum jami'an inshaAllah.